You may consider yourself a person of faith, but do you really know God?
Hello, welcome to the Ascent of Mount Carmel YouTube channel. If you've just stumbled onto this channel and you're watching one of these videos for the first time, it's probably a good idea to go back to the channel page and watch these in numerical order. It'd make a little more sense that way. We're discussing the book Ascent of Mount Carmel by St. John of the Cross. And in this chapter, St. John refers to creatures. In prior chapters, he used the term creatures as a metaphor for attachments. In this chapter, he's using the term in its literal sense. He's talking about things and creatures of the universe. St. John tells us that there's nothing that we can imagine that can possibly help the understanding better understand God or to act as a means to union with God. He's introducing this concept in this chapter, and he's going to explain it more fully in the next chapter. He tells us that in order to achieve something, the means must have some connection or resemblance with an end. For example, if we want to burn some paper, we need to heat at least a portion of the paper to 451 degrees Fahrenheit. The heat is a proper means to the fire because it has a resemblance and proportion to the fire. In a previous installment, we discussed how St. John tells us that to come to divine union, we need to do it through the theological virtue of faith, rather than the intellectual faculty of understanding. For the intellectual faculty of understanding to be united with God, we would need to employ a means that bears some resemblance to Him. The problem is that among all the creatures of the universe, from the highest to the lowest, there's nothing that comes near to God or bears any resemblance to Him. This is not to say that all creatures don't have some relation to God. After all, man was made in the image of God. However, we are still very, very distant from Him.
It's an indictment against what you don't have.
There's no essential resemblance or connection between any creature and God. Even the greatest of the saints and the angels bear no resemblance to Him. As a matter of fact, the distance between all things, including angels and God, is infinite. King David said in a psalm, "For the Lord is high and looks on the low, and the high He knows afar off." This means that God sees that we who are here on earth are below and very low in comparison with His lofty being. Even the higher creatures, as we just discussed, such as the angels, are very far from Him. Therefore, it's impossible for the intellectual faculty of understanding to attain divine union by means of anything or any creature, since there's no proportion or resemblance between those things and God. The understanding can understand nothing except which it already knows, and the imagination can only conceive of things that we've already witnessed or experienced through the bodily senses. And since we're talking about the supernatural, anything we may already know from the senses gives us no real preparation or capacity for receiving supernatural knowledge of God. When Moses asked for this knowledge, he was told by God that he would be unable to see Him. "Thou cannot see My face, for man shall not see Me and live." Scripture also referred to this in the Acts of the Apostles. "I am the God of your fathers, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob." And Moses, being terrified, did not dare behold. For as long as God was present, Moses knew that his understanding couldn't make any sense of God. Scripture also says, "No man has seen God at any time." Isaiah says, "From the beginning of the world, they have not heard nor perceived with the ears, the eye has not seen. O God, besides Thee, what things hast Thou prepared for them that wait for Thee?" When Elijah was in the presence of God, he covered his face. He needed to blind his understanding because he didn't dare look upon He that was so high. Elijah knew that whatever he was capable of seeing, he wouldn't be able to understand it clearly, and it would be very far from God and completely unlike Him. For all that can be understood by the understanding, that can be tasted by the will, and that can be invented by the imagination, it's all very unlike God and bears no proportion to Him.
The U.S. government has stressed no comparison can be drawn.
St. John tells us that the only way to approach God is through the purity of faith. There's nothing else that is proportionate and sufficient, And in order to reach him, a soul must proceed by blinding itself not just of the senses, but also of the understanding, and place itself in darkness. In this chapter, St. John defines mystical theology. He says it's where the understanding achieves the loftiest knowledge of God through contemplation. The wisdom of God is a secret even to the understanding that receives it. The understanding must be blind to all other paths that are open to it in order that it might be united to God. Just as the sun may as well be total darkness to a bat because that bat has no way to see or understand the sun, God is darkness to our understanding because we have no way to see or understand God through our faculty of understanding without faith. In summary, among all the things that can be apprehended by the faculty of understanding, there's no way in which the understanding can directly attain God. If the understanding tried to make use of all the things here that are available to it from our senses and from our experiences as approximate means to union, the things it understands would only be a hindrance, and it also likely result in numerous errors and delusions. So I hope you enjoyed this installment of Ascent of Mount Carmel. I hope you come back for the next one. In the meantime, please pray for the church.